Assalamu alaikum students, today we are going to learn about past indefinite tense or simple past tense. Past indefinite tense represents an action occurred in the past or a habit of the past. It is used to express an action that is just completed or just happened. So here we talk about the things happened or the action happened in the past or before and is not a current happening. Here we can talk about the past events using time expressions like Ali called last week. Here we used time expression last week. And we can also talk about the events that happened in the past without time expression. For example, I cooked dinner. Here we are not using time expression like we used in the previous sentence. We can talk about recent past. We can talk about distant past to indicate the actions or anything happened in the past. Now here in past indefinite tense, we have positive sentences, interrogative sentences and negative sentences. Here are the rules. With positive sentences, we use subject plus verb. We used second form of verb plus object. For example, I cooked dinner. Here we used second form of verb cooked. For the base form or the main form, cook. So this is how we make positive sentences. Now in the interrogative sentences, we use auxiliary verb did, D-I-D, did, plus subject plus main verb first form. You need to keep this in your mind that with did auxiliary verb, with did we used the main verb, the main form, first form, okay, plus object. For example, in the sentence, did you go to work today? Here we used auxiliary verb did, subject and main verb first form. Where is it? When we say work today, then we are using first form. Now next we have negative sentences. In negative sentences, we use subject plus did plus not plus verb but first form of verb, the base form, the main verb. Plus object. These are the rules. For example, I did not harm your pet dog. This is the example of negative sentence in past indefinite tense. I did not harm your pet dog. Here, I is subject. Did not harm, we are using auxiliary plus first form of verb. Object is your pet dog. I hope it is clear to you. Look at the chart to make your understanding more clear. Look at this chart. I went to the school. This is chart is of positive sentences. And here are the rules. For first person we use I, for first person plural we use we, for second person we use you, for third person singular we use he, she, for third person plural we use they, like boys. Now we have I went to the school. In the positive sentences, we use subject, I, verb, second form, went, and it is the second form of go. So we used second form. To the school, it is an object. So this is how we make positive sentences in simple past. Then if it is first person plural, then we use we went to the school. This is how we make positive sentences. Here are the examples of positive sentences. They appeared for the exam. She sang a song. In the same way, we have subject, second form of verb, and then object. This chart is for negative sentences. This is how you make negative sentences. Subject plus did not plus verb first form and object. As I mentioned this sentence in the above slide, that we with first person we use I. In the same way, I mentioned these things before. I did not harm your pet dog. We are gonna apply the rule in a same way, okay? But remember one point, that with auxiliary verb did, we use first form of verb. Main verb, base form. We use base form, okay? Now these are the examples. We have these sentences. I did not eat my lunch. We used subject, auxiliary verb did not, then first form of verb eat my lunch, object. This is how we are gonna make sentences, negative sentences. Next we have interrogative sentences. In interrogative sentences, we put auxiliary verb did first, then subject plus main verb first form plus object. Now here are the sentences. Did you go to the work today? Did you go to work today? Here did is auxiliary verb. We put first. You, subject, go to work today. We used first form of verb, main verb, work. So this is how we make interrogative sentences. That's all for today. I hope it is clear to you now. Thank you so much.